Hello, it's Linda Birdi at the Keyhole Heart Clinic. Today I want to talk to you about keyhole coronary artery bypass grafting. Now, just to give you an idea of what coronary artery bypass grafting is, or CABG, it's a method by which we use surgery to bypass blocks in heart arteries that create problems such as chest pain, angina, breathlessness, or even heart attack. And there are certain types of patients where symptom relief is the most important end result. And in others, it's not just about symptoms, it's about making patients live longer. So when we're trying to ascertain what is the best form of treatment, the best form of revascularization, we're always looking at both the symptoms that patients suffer and also what the long-term result of the treatment strategy is going to be. Now, traditionally, the treatment is surgery, where we stitch a flyover, a bypass graft that can be arteries from behind the breastbone, veins from the legs, or even arteries from the forearm, to try and create new tubes to bypass the blocks in the heart artery. It's a very successful treatment. It's been around for 50 plus years, and it really works. The problem is, most of the time, this procedure has to be done through the breastbone. And the breastbone is a fine incision, but it's a big one. It takes 12 weeks to heal. It does hurt a little bit. It bleeds a bit. And of course, if that bone gets infected, that's a big problem. Now, I would put into perspective, most heart surgery in the world is done through the breastbone. And I would never suggest for one moment it's a bad way to do surgery, because I do a lot of heart surgery through the breastbone. But if there is a way for us to do bypass grafting or revascularization by means other than breaking the breastbone, I think that really does bring some clinical value to the patients in expert hands. Now, the traditional type of keyhole bypass graft that we perform is something called MIDCAB, or minimally invasive direct coronary bypass grafting. Now, the typical procedure that we do here is a small cut between the ribs on the left-hand side. We harvest an artery from behind the breastbone called the left internal mammary artery, and we sew it to an artery on the front of the heart called the left anterior descending artery, LEMA to LAD. Now, this combination seems to confer the best long-term result and the best survival benefit for patients with coronary artery disease than any other thing that we can do for the heart. So if you've got a narrowing in the left anterior descending artery, we would always strongly recommend that surgery is the best way forward, particularly if it can be done through a small incision on the left side of the chest, which is pretty much nearly every time in experienced hands. Now, the more complicated situation is when we've got multiple diseases in the heart arteries. And of course, we can do 2, 3, or even 4 bypass grafts through this incision, and we can use arteries rather than veins. And of course, that's a fantastic result if we can achieve it, because of course, we've got a patient who will heal up in 7 or 8 days, less bleeding, less pain, less infection, all the other benefits. And of course, all the way through this, we're deciding whether or not we can achieve a result through here that is both short and long term in its efficacy. In certain types of patients, we can't reach the arteries through here, and we can combine surgery with stents. And the perfect combination, in my view, is LEMA to the LAD with surgery and grade 1 stenting to those heart arteries that are also blocked, but as long as the stents are going to give us a long-term result. And for those of you who don't know what stents are, these are little tubes that we can put into the coronary arteries through the groin without surgery at all. This combination of surgery and stents is called hybrid revascularization. Now, of course, there will be some patients where both hybrid revascularization and complete revascularization through the keyhole is not possible. And in those circumstances, we would always recommend that we go to the breastbone. What we're really trying to achieve here at the Keyhole Heart Clinic is an opportunity to look specifically at you as a patient to decide what we can achieve for you that is going to give us an excellent result based upon the data that we understand, the technological advancements that we've seen more recently, and also the skills that we have within the clinic, so that we can go all the way from complete keyhole all the way through to traditional surgery if that's what's required. Now, whatever I say about heart surgery, particularly if you've got coronary artery disease, if you need to have treatment, you don't need to worry about it. The treatments that we offer at the clinic and around the world are very safe and very efficacious. So if you've got a problem, get it dealt with and smile and be happy. That's all I want to say for now. If you want to know anything more about the work that we do, go to the YouTube or the Facebook pages. www.thekeyholeheartclinic.com is our website, and have a look peruse those and see if the information that we provide is what you need. If there's anything that you're not able to find, please do drop us a line and we'll try and fill in the gaps for you, because we're trying to inform you so that you can go to your local doctors, or indeed if you want to come and see us, so that we can try and find a way to develop a strategy for you that is the perfect solution. Bye for now.